ever since the very first YMCA on Asian soil founded in 1854 at Kolkata. The National Council of YMCAs of India has been proudly following the rich heritage and tradition of World YMCA in the Indian subcontinent. The Indian movement is widely spread across the nation in cities, towns and villages, alike by serving the communities, especially the youths. Our service upholds the image of YMCA as a tool to bring together diverse Indian society, regardless of its religion, caste, language and ethnicity. Further, I would like to say that the Indian YMCA is a blend of urban and rural YMCAs, reaching the youths and the marginalized through its projects and charitable endeavors.
Yes. The Indian YMCA movement is on the verge of creating a new history. For ages, it has been in the forefront of human development. It has scoring repeated success in its endeavor to bring about the largest possible impact on the vast majority of people, especially who are often overlooked, the disadvantaged and the dispossessed. It has also upheld the rights of youth by the grace of God. In India, since 1854, the Indian YMCA movement has been a continuous saga of selfless service for the cause of national building and nurturing youth. It is our pleasure and privilege to be providing within a span of next 45 minutes a comprehensive account of what makes the Indian YMCA pulsate. This docudrama captures some of the finest moments in the life and times of the Indian YMCA. It also contains an invitation to all those who wish to partner with us in this fast-moving success story. In our endeavor, you can also play a very proud part and feel enriched and enthused. I hope you will enjoy this presentation from the Indian YMCA. I welcome you all to India. Thank you.
Mid-19th century, industrial revolution in England, forcing thousands leaving the countryside for life in the city. Britain was caught unawares by the many evils and human sufferings caused by various factors, including overcrowding in London. London was the birthplace of YMCA. George Williams, a God-inspired businessman who founded YMCA to take care of the spiritual and human needs of young men who came from rural Britain to find living in the oppressive conditions of urban city.
Thank you. congratulate all members of the YMCA fraternity for their commendable work in rendering community service and for promoting youth development activities. I also congratulate you for achieving the 7th status in the world as a
member from each chapter, miss 100,000, 10,000 people from all over India. Month of October is a very good weather. We have a Mahatma Mandir, when there is a one of the biggest convention center in the India. So if you can decide today in your meeting, that in month of October, if you can organize all the 1,000 chapters in Gujarat, I'll be happy to host them. I'm happy to support them. Because the mission which you have taken regarding the youth empowerment is dear to my heart. So nowadays we are talking about the 21st century. People are saying that the 21st century will be the Asia century. Few people say that no, 21st century will be the China century. Few people say that no, 21st century will be the India century. Are we going to do anything or not? Simply we will wait that when we are going to get that chance. No, we'll have to work hard. Then only we can achieve this goal. And we are lucky, India is lucky, that today the 65% population of this country is the age group of below 35. 65% population of country is below 35. We are so lucky that we have such a huge young power with us.
Thomas Matthew. I belong to a rural YMCA. Throughout the journey with the YMCA, I nourished spiritual values and Christian values, which I uphold always in my life. YMCA in India belongs to the rural areas, which is the heart and soul of the Indian YMCA. Once Mahatma Gandhi said like this, the father of the nation, India lives in its villages. In a pluralistic and diversified nation like India, the rural YMCAs are marvelously bridging the communities for a harmonious and peaceful coexistence. Indian YMCA is the icon of social services and ecumenism in India. Hundreds and thousands of young people attracted to YMCA because of its social services and high moral values.
My name is Durgesh. I am studying Chinese in YMCA and staying here also. And my teachers are also good. They are excellent and have years of experience. Above all, they are very helpful.
Myself, Rumi. I am a housewife and dietitian also. I learn Chinese because I take this language to Chinese people and give I am a dietitian and take a dietitian knowledge to a Chinese people. This is a fast placement, good environment and nice faculty, and teacher is also very knowledgeable, and she knows already four languages. Yes. Bosha Shweshi Hanyo La YMCA Sheshe Zaichien by YMCA, and thanks YMCA.
As an ecumenical movement, YMCA has to take up leadership for the fostering dialogue and the partnership between people and different faiths and ideologies. YMCA should be highly instrumental in developing a society where oppressions, exploitation and denial of justice are to be confronted and transformed. I don't think that it is an impossible task, as the Indian YMCA is purely based on volunteerism. As a lady days, we are spending our valuable time, talent and treasure to take the movement into a greater height. This year, the Easter days were much productive. As we observed this Easter week, April 16 to 22, 2017, as a week of compassion, to identify with the poor, downtrodden, marginalized and needy around us. We were able to organize various programs and provided food, clothes, medicine and care to the needy. The interaction with the solitude of the inmates of the orphanages, poor old age retired homes, child care centers, home for the
President, Mr. Jacob Rajkumar, the Vice President, Reverend John Nelson Ali of the Calcutta YMCA, my dear friend Mr. Mani Kumar, National General Secretary. I must say that, you know, the dress you're wearing today, if you would have taken it off and waved it at the Lord's balcony, the entire balcony would have been covered with it. As I must say that, you know, I've been introduced all around the world by various people, but I extremely appreciated and enjoyed the way he used me, introduced me this evening. All of us know that YMCA's involvement in the development of the educational part of people's lives, the cultural part of people's lives, the way they go around developing the rural part of India, and basically making the life of the needy a very helpful and a good one and a life worth living. I hope you continue in your endeavor to make people's life a lot better. I'm amazed to see the length and the various members. They come from different parts of the country, different parts of the day. Their mission is the same. I've been told when I was sitting on the dais that you're going to start a new YMCA at Birmingham in London. Although I walked past the YMCA in Fitzroy Street, because I go there quite a lot in the Warren Street station and I go past it. It's been an institution which has helped the upliftment of youth and upliftment of people. To all those who are involved, it's a selfless service. To all those who have been a part of it for years to come, I know how much it takes to come out of your busy life and do social work. Hopefully you continue in doing that.
First of all, I must congratulate again for this closing ceremony of the 125th anniversary of India YMCA. And this presentation and all the speeches remind of this huge and beautiful legacy of your YMCAs with a long history. That's why I must congratulate. And from the APAY perspective, I witnessed and you have been providing outstanding leaders to APAY movement, not only Asia area, but worldwide. And from the perspective of APAY and world movement, you may know that our common consensus in the contemporary days is youth empowerment. So I want to see, after 5 years and 10 years, more young people are present here amongst all the gatherings, in each YMCA programs and gatherings. And another thing is gender justice and equity. In 5 years and 10 years, I'd like to see more women leaders like Kumari, and I see a few women there, over there, but more, maybe half of leaders and members will be women. I dream with YMCA, journey with Indian YMCA. I want to see that landscape in your future.
I bring you the warmest greetings from the YMCA Fellowship and the leadership of the African Alliance of YMCAs. I also bring you special greetings from our World YMCA Vice President, Ms. Evelyn Sadio, and from our General Secretary, Mr. Carlos Sambi. Both of them were to have joined me on this trip. But Ms. Gay could not be here because of work obligations. And as I'm speaking, Carlos is deeply involved in an end-of-year retreat for staff in Kenya. Both of them feel sad that they could not be here with me. And I do hope that being here alone does not diminish the interests and importance the African Alliance of YMCAs have in developing a genuine relations with our Indian movement.
Of the Asia-Pacific Alliance of YMCAs, I want to bring the heartiest greetings to you all. It's indeed a great pleasure for me to be here for the third time during my tenure as a president of Asia-Pacific Alliance of YMCAs. And every time I come to Kerala, all the times I have some new experience. I learn a lot. And I want to congratulate Dr. Levy Philip and his team for the outstanding work they are doing through the YMCA, especially the rural YMCA.
English,
YMCA is the visible expression of the interior response of George Williams to the deteriorating society. He met some people who are doing nothing. He said either they would become social helpers or they would become social destroyers. Which is very true. So he wanted them to be social helpers. And YMCA, he has designed it, he has organized it, he has planned it so that the world may not deteriorate, but a place very much, very much like heaven. And I am so glad that our present Indian president has understood the meaning of his vision and is following his vision. And with this new idea of the fellowship of all those people, India will become a very very large country with large vision and God's blessing. And I thank God for this great scheme and all that is involved in this great scheme. May God bless Mr. P.O. Philip, the Indian President, and his associates. bring about new India through the YMCA. God bless you.